Hey guys, welcome back. So we are just back in the car to go to Darwin. I'm on my new phone and the quality is like a bit too good. You know what I mean? Like, it's a bit too good, hun. Let's just like rein it in a little bit and like blur the skin, please. We're just packing. Well, we've packed already. I've just finished work and we've just had showers. We just got to get this into the car. We're not really taking much. We are selling the van as well. I'm viewing it to somebody, so we don't want to have like too much stuff in the car. You'll see from like the title of this video, but something exciting. We are finally getting our new car tomorrow. It's been like 3-4 months in the making and like years and years and years of wanting. Like, I've literally dreamed of having this car for my entire life. It's all ready and yeah, it's just waiting for us to collect it now. We've just sorted the insurance out. Feeling very poor right now, to be honest, but it's worth it. And we're selling the van, which is really sad, but not made any money, so we're gonna have to sell it. So we just pulled up to Adelaide River, which is like 45 minutes, it's like an hour for us probably, out of Darwin. But it's just got dark, well, it's like dusk. If you have been to Australia, you know that this is like bad time to drive. We've got kangaroos and bulls and buffalo. We decided to pull up and stop, and also we're just so tired. Like, Dave started work today at 5 a.m. I started at 6 a.m. like, we're just done in. So we bought the room, a budget room for $85, 2 single beds. Living. It's actually really bizarre to see buildings and traffic lights and like speed cameras. Look at that Wooo's, my god. Let's get to Darwin, this place here. So in 2022 we came on the plane from Brisbane and then we stayed at that, oh my god, we're here. We stayed at that place because it was right opposite the airport, and for some reason back then, well, probably because we'd just come from the city and also from England, we were literally thinking that we were in like the depths of the ghetto in like the desert. Like, that's what we were thinking. And there's a bus stop outside of it, and every time we go past the bus stop we remember like we were sat there literally like, what is going on? Like, it's a hotel that we stayed at, was proper like budget, like proper not nice, and it just makes us laugh. Like, if we knew back then that we were going to be driving past that same bus stop on our way to get a new car in our van that we've already done like half a lap of Australia in, and that we were sponsored, we would literally be like, you're like, but like, whoa, it's just such a 360 moment. And it's so funny because it's actually like, now that we look at it, it's just a bus stop and like a hotel on like the side of the highway. Like, it's actually fine, but back then we were literally like, oh my god, we are in like the ghetto. I had to pick the car up and there's like a problem on their side with the money. Like, we've sent the money but they can't confirm that we've sent the money. So we're just gonna go for breakfast and wait like an hour. So we've come to Cullen Bay. It's so nice. The sea's right there and it's just beautiful. Obviously I got beans on toast. What else would I be getting? They've got...
Looks lovely breakfast.
Dave's is very healthy.
Yeah,
there's nothing. Mine's like classic English. You know how when you vlog, it's embarrassing?
Yeah.
Like, everyone's embarrassed. And then I always tell myself, like, no, it's fine. No one's going to notice me.
Mm.
I'm speaking to the vlog.
Have you been
to that? Have we told you this story?
I was just thinking, I'm pretty sure you just told me.
I was trying to video the food and then this guy like stopped in his tracks when he saw me. I was like, yes, the food does look nice. I caught it on the vlog.
Sorry.
And I was like, don't notice me. Good ones. Okay, we're in Kmart now. Really shouldn't be here. Like, there's no need for us to be here, but we just need to be out of the sun. What's that one? Citrus and mint.
Citrus and mint, something nice. Would not recommend.
Kmart's basically like Primark, but like there. Milk frother. More cups because we keep breaking ours.
a rolling pin because we are now on the hype of making our own tutus,
thanks to our friend M. So now we make all of them and it's really good, but we've been using our Yeti, so we need a rolling pin. See, they even do paint. Every day, I want you come. It's just vibes in it, so good. Okay, basically what's happened is we're at the campsite now. So we went to go view the car to go collect it, and they were saying that I sent screenshots of the receipts of payment. Basically, we had to do it in like 6 transactions because of the daily limit. So we sent like 2 transactions, like one each on like 2 days ago, and then one each yesterday, and then one each today. Granted, we did leave it a little bit late, but I was unaware that we had this daily limit on the account for like bank transfers. So we did all that, that's fine. Everyone's like left our account, but basically there's a certain amount of money that's pending from Dave's account. Like, it's left his account, but it's pending, you know what it does, for like 24 hours. So now we need to wait till... So when they... now we need to wait. Oh my god, there's so many leaves coming in. The breeze is lovely, but we're right under a tree. I'm gonna get changed into my bikini and then we're gonna go to the lagoon. Dave said I have to come with him because apparently he's a baby chick and the mum's like yelling at him to get away from the baby chick.
Can you see it?
Can you see it?
Wait, where's it gone?
Yeah.
Oh!
The little chick! I've just got changed because we're gonna go to the lagoon now, but this is what like a typical camping toilet looks like. You know, we have like the toilets this side, the showers this side, and they're all right to be fair. Like, as long as there's no huntsmans in there, normally you're fine. And normally there is a huntsman, so normally on the ceiling there's a huntsman, but not in here today, so that's good. I actually don't know what's like wrong with my body, but if I stood in the sun for the length of time that Dave is standing in the sun trying to sort the car parking, I would simply pass away. Like, no doubt I would be heat stricken dead. I get heat stroke like so every day is heat stroke for me. Maybe I need to go to the doctors, but I went to the doctors and they said there was nothing wrong with my blood, so I don't know. But I just could never, like never. I literally walk out from like work to home every day. I walk to work in the dark, thank god. On the way home I walk in the daylight, like it's 2 p.m. and it sunburn. I'm obviously on Roaccutane, so it does burn me a little bit more, but literally I'm literally like dying, and then it'll give me a headache for the rest of the day. But Dave is really just in the sun right now and it's stressing me out. Come back to the shade. Well, we're parked up in this car park. The lagoon is just through there and the sea is just there, and it's so lovely. The lagoon here is like, they've just like put barriers, I hope they've put barriers at like the sea edge, and then like they've made like a man-made little beach thing with the seawater, so it's like actually like you're still swimming in the sea, but there's no crocodiles and stingers, which is a plus. I bought some books. These are the books that I've got at the moment, but quite the collection, because I got some and then my mum bought me one for my birthday and I just haven't read them yet, so I've got like a collection going on. So I've got this one, which I think I bought this one and my mum bought me this one. I think I've started this, yeah I have. And then I got onto my, like, basically my anxiety at the moment, and he dropped it, is like really extreme. And I think it's because, especially my social anxiety, which I've always had anxiety, but like it's extreme right now. Like, I literally am so socially anxious. Like, I think it's because of where we live, because I've always had a bit of social anxiety, but I really worked on it. Like, I used to never be able to get public transport by myself, which is like, it sounds ridiculous, but like anxiety is like sometimes ridiculous. And like over the most non-expecting things you can be anxious about. But I really worked on it and like forced myself and like pushed myself out of my comfort zone. Like, I used to, because I moved home from uni in year 3, so I had to get the train up by myself each week, and like that really helped my social anxiety and like just general anxiety.
and I really worked on it, but I feel like since we've been living in Mataranka, because literally the people I see are the people that live in the town and like tourists, and I don't know, like we don't really communicate much with people. I don't know how to explain it, because it's not like we live in literally the arse end of absolute nowhere, even though we do kind of. It's just, I think it does not help the anxiety when that's where you live, like in the outback. I just don't think, because I'm not putting myself out my comfort so much at all. Like every day is like the same.
So I bought these to try and like heal my anxiety. This one is Healing is the New High by Vex King, and I've heard that Vex King's books are really good. And then this one, Why Has Nobody Told Me This Before? I just got this one today from Kmart, and this like make anxiety disappear.
And I've also bought, they're in this bag so I can't get them out, but I bought two like crime books, because I've got like two love books, two self-help books, and I need like some criminal books, like thriller books. They're literally my favorite books ever, so I'm gonna take them today and read that. I can't really be bothered to have the self-help today. I've had enough of a day as it is. I can't be bothered with emotional healing today. That can start tomorrow. Yeah, in the shape of God. And we just got our books. I've got, this is the crime one, and Dave's got his one there. And we got, I haven't seen these in Australia yet, so I picked these up because we went to the shop to get some water. And I got some Doritos, Dave got some nuts, and just honest to God, look at it, it's just beautiful. It's like bars and stuff all behind us. yeah, we're just gonna relax. Chillax him. We've been here for like 3 hours now, and we're just so based. We've been reading our book, went for a swim, and I just literally cannot believe that this is free. Like, the parking's free. It's a Saturday, so like that's just like an added bonus. Like, you kind of expect parking to be free in the week, but it's free on the weekends. And then the like this lagoon, it's free. Like, it's just all free. There's not a single purchase made. It's a good job it's free, because we bought a car and we're very poor right now. I started my book, it's really good, and I ate my drumsticks and I ate my Doritos, and they were really yum. Gonna get a good feed tonight. Probably, I'm feeling like a burrito. What about you?
Chinese
hurt, does not hurt.
We are rushing. We decided that we want a GYG, which is like a burrito place, and we are rushing because the sun. She's still up, but you can see it's very golden, and we want to watch the sunset at the beach with our GYG. So we're like, pedal to the metal, let's go. Our GYG. Secured! Got burrito each, bottle of water. We've parked up here.
Just need some dolphins.
Oh, yeah. This is why Darwin's so special, like literally nobody here. And look at the view.
If this was Bondi.
You have to stand on your head to get a space. GYG.
Apparently it's a submarine in the port.
Oh really? Probably. Someone's fishing down there.
Still warm.
Wow. It's so pretty. It's nearly gone, guys. Still tucking into the burrito. Look at that. What a combo.
It's so pretty. We're just lying down. I think there's a film on at the outdoor cinema. We are just waiting for the people to get back from their test drive. Dave's on the phone to Wilma, the agent. That
no
we're
worries,
buying the
we'll probably be there by 10-ish, I'm guessing. No worries, thank you, bye.
So we've just been to see the people that want to buy the car. I think they are keen, it's really hard to tell, isn't it? It's so awkward, like literally so awkward. But. Yeah, they're gonna like look into, because ours is Queens and Reggio and we're in the NT, so they wanna look into how to like transfer that over and stuff. But we're just on the way to collect the car now. I feel like we're both really drained from this weekend. There hasn't even, I don't know, there's just been a lot going on.
A lot of emotional
roller coaster in such a short amount of time. Just feeling a bit drained, I won't lie. But we're trying to get pumped to get on a new car. But honestly, just want to go back home and like go to bed. Like the work week starts tomorrow, like it's straight back into it, 6 a.m. It's just been a lot, but we're nearly there. But hopefully, the person wants to buy the van, she needs to leave by the 25th, she's going back to Queensland, so hopefully she wants to buy it today. That would be like best case scenario. Buys it today, we can just drive home in the new car. But yeah, we'll keep you posted. But yeah, the next videos are going to be of the new car, but I'm probably a little bit shy, so sorry if the filming's a little bit. How's your father? I literally cannot believe that we've got this car. This is she. We got a 270 awning, rooftop tent, five door, yeah, I think so. Five door, lift kit, new tyres. Look at them tyres. Four-wheel drive ones. It's literally, oh, it's locked. It's so insane. It smells so new, like it's literally brand new, 2024. Like, as if we've just done this.
Can't believe it.
How good.
Surreal.
Okay, so the girl is like, 99.9% gonna buy the van today. We've reduced the price, but at this point we don't want to drive the van back to Matarenka and then drive back up.
So I just filmed like a whole thing, but it didn't record when I was in the car earlier. But I was saying about how the girl that wants to buy the van offered us a lower price and we've just accepted it, and whether the like they'd buy it today, and she's just like confirmed it all, so we are selling it today. And we're just like packing everything up, and it's so sad. Like, I literally feel so sad about it. Feels like an end of an era.
Yeah, because when I tell you, I've just had the most stressful moment of my entire life. So Dave was following me in the van because we're gonna drop it off to the girl now, and he just disappeared. Like, I turned down where I was meant to turn and he just didn't follow me. So I originally pulled up in this lay-by. I was like, he'll drive past me in a minute and I'll follow him and I'll lead again. 10 minutes passed, he didn't turn up, and I was like, Jesus Christ, he's gone the wrong way. I was like, right, okay, I'll go to the house, see if he makes it there. He didn't make it there. He doesn't know the way around Darwin. So then I had to go drive back to where he was, where I last saw him. He wasn't there. I drove the way that he could have gone, like the other way that he could have gone, drove like 20 k's out, didn't see him, couldn't see him. Just got a no caller ID text. And then finally he's texted me. Basically he had no charge in his phone. That's a crucial bit of information. He had no charge in his phone to find anywhere on the map or ring me or anything like that. So he's had no address, no phone, nothing. So he's just had to go to a server apparently to get a charger, to charge his phone up. And then he's gonna have to like pay afterwards or something. And then now he's on his way. Honest to God, the stress of that. I've just been driving around. It was like a needle in a haystack. Driving a new car, trying to find him. I was literally looking down all the side streets trying to find him, couldn't find him anywhere. Looking at all the servos because I thought he'll go to a servo, couldn't see him. So that was genuinely the most stressful thing ever. It's been like an hour of looking for him.
Okay, we've done our Chemist Warehouse shop and we just got a Subway.
We're finally, first breather of the weekend.
Sold the van, we've dropped it off, sold it, got the money, it's all done. Got our car. And I said, if we can't de-stress and relax now, then there's actually something wrong with us, because everything should be sorted now. So we're going to eat this and enjoy
the drive home.
Cheers.
Just had Subway. We did a Chemist Warehouse shop, which is always extortionate price. You don't want to know. Free bags. You don't want them. Just filled up our first round of petrol. I used 2 bars of petrol trying to find Dave. That's how long and far I went. And we don't know yet like how far it can get us, so we're just filling up. We're only 2 bars down, but we're just filling up just in case. Because we've got to go like 5 hours or 4 hours back to Barrington. But yeah, we're loving it. We're absolutely loving it. And I'm just going to end this video here. I don't know if it's like a good video or not, because I feel like we're in quite bad moods for a lot of it, unfortunately for you guys. But it's just been a lot this weekend. But finally, it seems like everything's sorted and it's going to be okay. Sometimes it can be really overwhelming trying to fix every single thing. Like, you're literally starting from fresh when you move to a new country. And then when you're like a backpacker, it's kind of like semi starting from fresh. But when you actually like decide, oh, I want to live here forever, you really, really have to like start from scratch. And that's what we've been doing. And it's been a really long time coming. And like, we've been questioning, like, is this the right decision? Like, buying this car, is it the right decision? Like, getting rid of the van, like, all these emotions for like the past 4 months. So yeah, we're glad that it's finally happened. We're glad that it's finally just like done out of our hands. It's done now and we can enjoy the new car and like so many more adventures to come. A rooftop tent, I need to show you it as well. We haven't even looked at that yet. We've got the awning, which we haven't even got out yet. And we've got so much fun and happiness to come. And I can't wait to like show our family this car. I'm so proud of us. Like, we worked our absolute asses off to get this car. And finally, some guy's just still vlogging. He's interrupted my emotional moment. But finally, we're reaping the rewards of our hard work, which is really, really nice. Any final words for the vlog?
It's been
it's been a journey.
Let's hope we make it home.
Peace out.
We can get like cushions for the ladder.